Polymers are giant or macro molecules of high molecular weight. Their relative molecular mass ranges from a few thousand to over several millions. They are built up by repetition of small chemical units, also known as monomers, held together by covalent bonds. In the case of plastics, its monomers are ethene. Likewise, a monomer is any substance that can be converted into a polymer. A repeat unit is the repeating segment which comprises a polymer. A polymer is usually represented by the following notation, or as a section of the polymer showing M repeat units. There are two main types of polymerization, the first being addition polymerization, which involves the addition reactions of alkenes or other compounds containing double bonds, otherwise known as unsaturated bonds. Examples of these include polyethane and polystyrene. The second type of polymerization is condensation polymerization, which involves the reaction of two or more molecules with the concurrent loss of water. Examples of these would be terylene and nylon. However, in this project, we choose to focus on plastic, which is an example of addition polymerization. As mentioned earlier, addition polymerization involves the linking together of simple unsaturated molecules such as alkenes. The relative molecular mass of the polymer equals to n times the relative molecular mass of the monomer, where n is known as the degree of polymerization. This represents the number of units in the polymer chain and specifies length of the chain, and hence the molecular weight. Moving on to the properties of plastics. Plastics are durable due to the strong covalent bonds between their repeating units. Also, plastics are waterproof because they are long and compact hydrocarbon chains, this allowing water molecules to pass through them. Moreover, plastics are cheap, readily available, and light. Plastics, on the flip side, brings about many environmental concerns. They are non-biodegradable due to its complicated composition, which means they cannot be decomposed by bacteria in the ground. Hence, discarded plastic materials pollute the ground and water. Although plastics can be destroyed by burning, incomplete combustion can cause production of toxic carbon monoxide and plenty of soot. Also, 93% of marine debris consists of plastic bags. They clog digestive tracts when consumed, causing starvation through restricting movement of food or tricking the marine animal into thinking it's full. Therefore, incorrect disposal of plastics would bring about disastrous effects to the earth and wildlife.
Cool.
Yeah, actually I agree with you. I think every material has its
solution for the time being is to learn how to reuse, reduce, and recycle. Hey, you know, actually a few days ago I read about an article talking about this biodegradable plastic bags, but currently research is still being done on it and it's not commercially available yet. But I believe it's a promising solution for our environmental problems.
That sounds interesting. But anyway, for now, let us
reuse, reduce, and recycle.